Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Tempo Strategy Legends of Runeterra deck spotlight. Monuments of Power has had some time to sort itself out, and one of the strongest cards to emerge from the set is undeniably Grand Plaza. The card has enabled multiple powerful Demacia-based strategies that give its controller incredible control over the combat step. The Grand Plaza has opened up strategies in Targon with Leona Lux or Garen Aesol. In Shadow Isles, a more aggressive ephemeral-based strategy has also proven itself to be a highly respected deck in the current format. In this video, we will dive into Ephemeral Plaza to get a better understanding of the strategy as a whole. Before we get into things, please take a moment to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. While you're at it, make sure you click the bell icon to get notified whenever we come out with more Legends of Runeterra strategy content. Ephemeral Plaza is a board-centric beatdown deck that aims to accrue value through Grand Plaza. The strategy is built to maximize on this card, and as such is heavily incentivized to aggressively mulligan for the Grand Plaza, as the deck gets significantly better with the Grand Plaza on turn 3. If Plaza can enter play on turn 3, the deck is able to take early control of the board using Haunted Relic or Onslaught of Shadows to set up solid value trades. Since the strategy is in the market for ephemerals, Shark Chariot finally finds a home in the format. The buff from the Grand Plaza is huge on the turn you initially play the Chariot, allowing it to trade with another unit on top of being a recursive threat throughout the game. This strategy is able to use its ephemerals effectively with its champions as well, setting up surprise level up plays with Lucian, or even getting Hakarim leveled up on curve. Though Ephemeral Plaza can have explosive openers, this is not to say the deck is exclusively an aggro deck. Ephemeral Plaza can actually play a reasonably long game. The strategy often looks to play at least one form of healing between Darkwater Scourge or Radiant Guardian. Alongside the Rekindler, you have a mid-range strategy that can set up huge damage swing turns by controlling the flow of combat, setting up rally attacks, and getting double strike attack hits in with Senna or Lucian. When mulliganing with Ephemeral Plaza, the top priority card is its namesake, the Grand Plaza. You should look to aggressively mulligan for it. Some other solid keeps are Lucian or Shark Chariot, which will help you pressure early. If you already have the Grand Plaza, you should consider keeping Haunted Relic or Onslaught of Shadows, as they will allow you to set up huge attacks if you bank mana early. When fighting an aggressive matchup, consider keeping your healing options in Radiant Guardian and Darkwater Scourge, as they will help you stabilize. Against slower matchups, you may want more value-oriented cards, such as Grizzled Ranger, Hakarim, or the Rekindler. Be careful when doing this, as you don't want a hand that is too greedy, and end up with no plays early. For Ephemeral Plaza, the early game is generally simple. If you are attacking on odds, you will want to set up the Grand Plaza on turn 3, and back it up with Haunted Relic or Onslaught of Shadows to stabilize the board. If you are attacking on evens, however, you should look to have either Lucian or Shark Chariot on turn 2, followed up with Grizzled Ranger on 4. Ideally, of course, with the Grand Plaza on turn 3. For this deck, the early games are best spent setting up for your more explosive mid-game turns. During these turns, you should be looking to set up tempo-efficient plays. You may be able to sneak Lucian and Senna into play, which will often be difficult for the opponent to safely disarm. You may also have the ability to set up wide attacks, where you can force through large amounts of damage by using your ephemeral units to challenge your opponent's board and clearing the way for your more important units. As the mid-game comes to a close, if you were the aggressor, you may have the opportunity to land Hakarim, who in many cases may be leveled up, which will set up game-ending attacks. If you were the defender, on the other hand, it is possible you will need to set up defensive turns with Radiant Guardian and Darkwater Scourge to help bridge you into the late game. Players have access to 7 mana by now, and players are now dropping their haymakers. At this point, you should have either pressured your opponent heavily if you were the aggressor, or have just stabilized against the aggressive decks. Ephemeral Plaza has great closing power with the Rekindler, which will set up incredibly wide attacks in a single action. At this point in the game, you may also be able to set up combo turns with Chronicler of Ruin, using him to level Lucian, or get a surprise rally with him. During these turns, you should be trying to figure out the best way for you to set up lethal attacks while not leaving yourself vulnerable to the enemy's crackbacks. The Grand Plaza is the definition of a meta-defining card, and this is only one of the strategies that the card has enabled. While it is tough to say so early on what the best way to utilize the card is, it is very clear that Ephemeral Plaza is one of the front runners for the archetype. Have you tried the Grand Plaza yet? If you have, let us know in the comments which champions you've tried it with. If you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching. See you all next time.